Today we will learn maxima and minima. This is the most important topic of this chapter. In board exam, we can expect one question from this topic. Usually we get a 6-mark question. Almost 99, 100% sure we will get one 6-mark question from maxima and minima. And here we are using derivatives for finding maximum value of a function and the minimum value of a function. So that is application of derivatives. By using derivative we will find the maximum and the minimum value of a function. So first we are going to learn what is mean by maxima, what is mean by minima. So we can take one example. We can draw the graph of a function y is equal to f of x. Suppose it is the graph of a function y is equal to f of x, and this function is defined in open interval AB. Open interval AB. F is a function defined in open interval AB. And if f is said to have maximum in AB, f is said to have maximum value in AB, in open interval AB. F is said to have maximum value in open interval AB. then there exists a point C belongs to open interval AB such that f of C greater than f of x for every x belongs to open interval AB. Then we can say that f of C is the maximum value of the function and the C is the point of maximum value. Then f of C is called the maximum value of f and C is called the point of maximum value. So here we can see domain we can mark in x axis. So here the function defined in open interval AB. So here this is the domain. And the range of the function we mark in y axis. So we know from here we can say the function is increasing. And I think up to here the function is increasing. Then the function is decreasing. So here this function is increasing and then right side of that point it is decreasing. So let that point be C and the corresponding f of x, that is f of C. So here this is the maximum value of f of x. F of C is the maximum value of f of x and f of x is maximum at C. So we can say that the C is the point of maxima and f of C is called a point of, f of C is called a maximum value of f of x, maximum value of the function, and C is the point of maximum value, point of maximum value. So here we can take when we take this point the corresponding f of x here, when we take another point here the corresponding f of x here, and if you take a point here f of x here, so this f of C at C f of x, that is f of C, that f of C is greater than f of x for every x belongs to AB. So when we take any number in between A and B, then at C f of C is maximum. So we can say f of C is greater than f of x for every x belongs to AB. So f is said to have maximum value in AB. There is a point C in AB such that f of C is greater than f of x for every x belongs to AB. And here f of C is called the maximum value of the function and C is called a point of maximum value. Then similarly we can find the minimum value of the function and the point of minimum value. Here suppose the function, this is the function defined in open interval AB. This is the function defined in open interval AB. And here also y is equal to f of x, that is the function. And here we can find f of x etc. here for all the points. But for one particular point, So here, see. So at this point, f of x is minimum. So here that is f of c. F of x is minimum at this point. So we can say that f is a function defined in open interval AB. Then f is said to have minimum value in AB. There is a point c belongs to open interval AB such that f of c less than f of x for every x belongs to open interval AB. Then we can say that this point, this is the minimum value of f of x, and c, this is the minimum value of f of x, and c is the point of minimum value. So minimum value of f of x, point of minimum value. So this is called a minima and this is called a maxima. Then point of minima, point of maxima. Then now we are, this is maximum value, minimum value, point of maximum value, point of minimum value. Now we are going to learn local maximum value, local minimum value, then point of local maxima, point of local minima. So we can draw another graph. We can take another function. And here, suppose f of x. So here, this is a function defined in interval AB. Open interval AB. This is a function defined in open interval AB. And here the function is increasing, then again decreasing. So this is one maximum value. And here this is another, this is one minimum value. And this is one maximum value. This is one minimum value. And this is one maximum value. So here maximum value, this is maximum value. Then this is point of maxima, and this is point of maxima, and this is also point of maxima, point of maxima, point of maxima, point of maxima, and here point of minima, point of minima. So here local maxima and local minima. Now we are going to find the local maximum value and the local minimum value. So when we take this point, so in the neighborhood of this point, in the neighborhood of this point, this is maximum. But when we take this entire interval, this is the maximum value. When we take this entire interval, so this is maximum value, because this is greater than this one, and this point is greater than this one. So the corresponding f of c. So this is maximum value. But when we take this small interval, or in the neighborhood of this point, this is maximum. And in the neighborhood of this one, this is maximum. And in the small neighborhood of this one, this will be maximum. So we can say that this is the local maximum value, and this is the point of local maxima, local maximum value, point of local maxima, and the local maximum value, point of local maxima. So here, f is a function defined in set of real numbers or in an interval. Then if f is said to have local maxima in AB, if there exists a point, if there exists a point C belongs to the neighborhood of that point. That means if there exists a point C belongs to the neighborhood of C, that means C minus H, C plus H, where H is a small quantity greater than 0. So C minus H. So suppose this is point C, then here C minus H, C plus H. So in this interval, in this neighborhood, F is maximum. So we can say that in this neighborhood, there exists a point C belongs to open interval C minus H, C minus H, C plus H, such that F of C greater than F of X for every X belongs to C minus H, C plus H. So here we can say that In that case, we can say f of c greater than f of x for every x belongs to c minus h, c plus h. So we can say f is the local maximum value. So local maximum value means in that particular neighborhood, the function f is maximum. And here, when we take this neighborhood, this function is maximum. And this is the point of local maxima. And this is also point of local maxima. And point of local maxima. And here in this neighborhood, the function is maximum. And similarly, local minima. So here, this is a minimum value. And this is also a minimum value. And here, in this small interval, this is the minimum value. Because here it is decreasing, then it is again increasing. So this is the point of local minima. And this is local minimum value. And this is the point of local maxima. This is the point of local maxima. Sorry, local minima. And this is a local minimum value because this is the minimum in this small neighborhood. So we can say that if f is said to have local minimum value in the given interval, then there is a point of c belongs to c minus h, c plus h, such that f of c less than f of x for every x belongs to c minus h, c plus h. So in that small interval, if f of c less than f of x for every x belongs to that small interval, then we can say that this is the local minimum value and that point c is the point of local minimum. So but when we take that entire interval, this is the maximum. So this is called absolute maximum value. And this is called absolute maximum value because this is greater than all the local maxima. This is local maxima and local maxima. And this one is greater than all the local maxima. So this is called absolute maximum value. And similarly, this is local minima. Then this is the smallest one. So this is called absolute local minima. Absolute minimum value, absolute maximum value. This is absolute maximum value, this is absolute minimum value, and these three points are local maxima, and these two points are local minima. So that is the difference between local maxima, local minima, and absolute maximum, absolute minimum, etc. So in this chapter we are going to learn how to find the local maximum value of a function or local minimum value of a function or point of local maxima, point of local minima, etc. So here we have two different methods. First one is first derivative test and the second one is second derivative test. Second derivative test. So by using these two methods, we can find the point of local maxima, local maximum value, local minimum value, point of local minima, etc. First derivative test and the second derivative test. And in first derivative test, suppose this is the graph of y is equal to f of x. Or this is one graph. And here, this is the point of local maximum and this is the local maximum value, f of c. And this is the point of local minimum and this is the local minimum value. Point of local maximum value, point of local minimum value. And here, if this is the point of local maximum, then the left side the function is increasing and the right side the function is decreasing. So if the function is increasing, then in previous section we learned, if the function is increasing, then f dash x will be greater than 0. That means f dash x is positive, increasing function. And if the function is decreasing in a particular interval, then f dash x will be less than 0 in that interval. That means here, if left side it is positive and right side it is negative, then we can say that the function is increasing, then decreasing. So that point will be the point of local maxima, and the corresponding f of c, that is a maximum value, local maximum value. So once again, if c is the point of local maxima, if c is the point of local maxima, then the function is increasing left side of c and decreasing right side of c. Or we can say that f dash x greater than 0, left side of c, and f dash x less than 0, right side of c, then we can say the function is increasing, then decreasing. So this is the point of local maxima. Or we can say that if the function is positive, left side of c, and the negative, right side of c, or the function is changing the sign from positive to negative, if the function is changing the sign, if f dash x is changing the sign from positive to negative, not a function, f dash x. If f dash x is changing the sign from positive to negative, when x is increasing through c, then we can say that the function is, the point c is point of local maximum. And here this function is decreasing. So left side of c, f dash x less than 0, or left side of c, f dash x is negative. And here the function is increasing, so f dash x will be greater than 0, or we can say positive. So here f dash x changes the sign from negative to positive as x increases through the point c. F dash x changes the sign from negative to positive as x increases through point c. So in that case we can say that c is the point of local minima and f of c is the local minimum value. So if f dash x is negative, left side of c, and f dash x is positive, right side of c, then c is the point of local minimum. So that is the first derivative test. So in first derivative test we are doing like this. The function will be given, equation of the curve will be given. Suppose f of x is equal to x cube minus 3x plus 3. F of x is equal to x cube plus 3x minus x cube minus 3x plus 3. This is equation of the curve. Then we need to find the point of local maxima and local minima. Find all the points of local maxima and local minima of the function. And if we do this question by first derivative test, first we have to find f dash x. F dash x is equal to 3x square minus 3. F dash x is equal to 3x square minus 3. Then f dash x equal to 0 implies 3x square minus 3 equal to 0. That is 3 into x square minus 1 equal to 0. That is 3 into x plus 1 into x minus 1 equal to 0. Therefore x is equal to minus 1, x is equal to plus 1. So we got the critical point, turning points. Now we will draw the graph line. And minus 1 here and plus 1 here. Then we will check the sign of f dash x. So we have to, if it is increasing, if the function is, if it is a point of local maxima, then f dash x will be greater than 0 left side, and f dash x will be less than 0 right side. And if it is point of local minima, that means here positive, then negative. And if it is negative to positive, that means this is the point of local minima. And if it is positive to negative, then the point of local maxima. So now we got two points here, minus 1 and 1. So one of them is the point of local maxima and the other one is point of local minima. So we need to check properly. For this we need to find the sign of f dash x. So left side of minus 1, what is the sign of f dash x? So this is f dash x. F dash x is this one. So left side of minus 1. So we can take one number. Left side of minus 1. Suppose it is minus 2. Then when we replace x by minus 2. 3 is positive. Then minus 2 plus 1. That is negative. Here positive. Then negative. Then minus 2. Minus 2. When we replace x by minus 2. Left side of minus 1 we are taking one number. That is minus 2. Minus 2. Plus 1, that is minus 1, that is negative. Then minus 2 minus 1, that is again negative. So positive into negative, so the sign is positive here. Then in between minus 1 and 1, we can take one number, we can take 0, and when we replace x by 0, so here it is 0 plus 1, that is positive, 0 minus 1, that is negative. So this sign is positive into negative, that is negative. Then right side of 1, we can take 2, 2 plus 1, positive, 2 minus 1, again positive, 2 plus 1, positive, 2 minus 1, that is 1, that is positive, and here positive. So here, f dash x is positive, or we can write them, f dash x is positive, that means f dash x greater than 0, and here f dash x negative, less than 0, and here f dash x are positive, greater than 0. So, here f dash x changes the sign from positive to negative, as x increases through minus 1. So, positive to negative, that means f dash x is greater than 0, then less than 0, that is this one, f dash x, left side positive, right side negative, that means minus 1 is the point of local maxima. So we can say that therefore minus 1 is the, we will write minus 1 is the point of local maxima, and here at 1 the sign will be a sign changing from negative to positive, that means f dash x less than 0, left side of 1, and f dash x greater than 0, right side of 1, that means here it is a decreasing then increasing, so decreasing then increasing, so this point is point of local minima. So minus 1 is the point of local maxima, and 1 is the point of local minima. And if you want to find the local maximum value, so local maximum value is equal to f of, local maximum value is equal to f of minus 1, and the local minimum value equal to f of 1. So f of minus 1, when we replace x by minus 1, we will get a local maximum value, and when we replace x by plus 1, we will get a local minimum value. So once again I will explain the first derivative test. So we will get the equation of the curve, f of x is equal to this one. Then first we have to find its derivative, f dash x. F dash x we will get, f dash x is equal to 3 square minus 3. Then when f dash x is equal to 0, find the values of x. These are the critical points, find the values of x. And that points are point of local maxima, point of local minima, etc. So these are the critical points, that means from that point the graph sign is changing, negative to positive or positive to negative, etc. And here minus 1 and 1 we got here, then we will draw a number line and we will locate that two points, minus 1 and 1, and we will find the sign of f dash x, not sign of f of x, we will find the sign of f dash x. And here we can easily find, we will take one number, left side of minus 1, and replace here, then here it is positive, and here it is negative, and here it is positive. So here, f dash x positive to negative, that means f dash x greater than 0, and less than, left side of minus 1, f dash x greater than 0, right side of minus 1, f dash x less than 0. That means f dash x greater than 0, that is increasing. And right side, f dash x less than 0 decreasing. That means that point is the point of local maxima. So minus 1 is the point of local maxima. And here, left side of 1, it is decreasing. And right side, it is increasing. Because it is negative, f dash x less than 0. Positive, f dash x greater than 0. So decreasing, then increasing. So this point is called a point of, 1 is the point of local minima. Now we have to find the local maximum value. So local maximum value is f of minus 1. Because minus 1 is the point of local maxima, so f of minus 1. Then local minimum value is, 1 is the point of local minima, so local minimum value is f of 1. So when we replace x by minus 1 here, we will get a local maximum value. And when we replace x by plus 1 here, we will get a local minimum value. So this is first derivative test. And here we have one more possibility. Sometimes we may get a left side of minus 1 and the right side of minus 1, we may get the same sign. So if we get the same sign, then this is neither point of local maxima nor point of local minima, and that point is called point of inflection. So this is called a point of inflection. Point of inflection. So that is called a point of inflection. F dash x does not change the sign as x increases through c. Is neither point of local maxima nor point of local minima. Such a point is called a point of inflection. So if we get the same sign, both the sides, then it will be point of inflection. So that is first derivative test. Then the second derivative test. So this is first derivative test, and in second derivative test, we can take same example. F of x is equal to x cube minus 3x plus 3. Then we will find f dash x, 3x square minus 3. Then f dash x equal to 0 implies 3x square minus 3 equal to 0. Up to here same. Therefore x is equal to minus 1 and x is equal to plus 1. Up to here it will be same for second derivative test. F of x will be given. We will find f dash x. And when f dash x is equal to 0, find the values of x. Then we will not draw this number line in second derivative. Then from here we will find f double dash x. F double dash x. That means second derivative of f of x. Or we will differentiate f dash x once again. Then when we find f double dash x, that is 6x. Then f double dash x at x is equal to minus 1, we will find f double dash x at x is equal to plus 1, we will find. So once again, up to here is same. We will find the critical point in both the questions. In first derivative test, after getting the critical point, we will draw the number line and we will find the sign, positive, negative, positive, etc. Then we will decide whether it is increasing, decreasing, etc. Then we can find a point of local maxima, point of local minima, etc. But in second derivative test, after getting the critical point, we will find the second derivative. And second derivative at minus 1 we will calculate, second derivative at plus 1 we will find. And if this value, if second derivative at minus 1, if it is negative, that means if it is less than 0 or if it is negative, then this is the point of local maxima. If second derivative is negative, if it is negative, then this is the point of local maxima. And if it is positive, if it is greater than 0, this is the point of local minima. So here we can find, we got f double dash x 6x. So that is equal to 6x, then we can replace x by minus 1, x is equal to minus 1. That is 6 into minus 1, that is minus 6, less than 0. And here, f double dash x, that is 6x. And here, we can replace x is equal to 1. Then that is equal to 6 greater than 0. So here, it is negative. So we can say that minus 1 is the point of local maxima. And here it is positive, therefore 1 is the point of local minima. Minus 1 is the point of local maxima, 1 is the point of local minima. Same answer we got. So minus 1. So here f double dash x less than 0, therefore minus 1 is point of local maxima. So here we will write up. If f double dash x less than 0, then point of local maxima, and if f double dash x greater than 0, point of local minima. So here f double dash x, that is 6x, and f double dash x at x is equal to minus 1, that is minus 6 less than 0, therefore minus 1 is the point of local maxima. Minus 1 is the point of local maxima. And the local maximum value, that is f of minus 1. f of minus 1 is the local maximum value and minus 1 is the point of local maximum. And here, this is greater than 0. And if f double dash is greater than 0, that is point of local minima. So, 1 is the point of local minima and f of 1 is the local minimum value. And here we have one more possibility. That possibility is f double dash x, here it is negative and here it is positive. Sometimes we may get f double dash x equal to 0. F double dash x equal to 0. So, if f double dash x equal to 0, then the second derivative test fails. Second derivative test failed if f double dash x greater than equal to 0. In that case, we will stop there and we will do it by first derivative test. So that is important point. So in case, if the second derivative is 0, if second derivative equal to 0, then we cannot continue. We cannot do that question by second derivative test. Second derivative test failed there. So we will do it by first derivative test. That means we will draw the number line. Then we will locate the points. Then we will find the positive sign, negative sign, etc. Then we will find the point of local maxima, local minima. Then local maximum value, local minimum value. So these are the two tests we are using for finding point of local maxima, local maximum value, point of local minimum value. First derivative test and the second derivative test. So once again, in both the tests, first f of x will be given in question. We will find f dash x, and when f dash x equal to 0, find the points. In both the tests, up to critical point, we will find same. Up to critical point, it is same. Then in first derivative test, after getting the critical point, we will draw the number line. We will locate the points. We will find the sign. And if it is positive to negative, that means increasing and decreasing. That means a point of local maximum. And if it is negative to positive, that is a decreasing, then increasing. So point of local minimum. Then we can find the local maximum value and the local minimum value. And if it is, if the sign is same, both the side, the sign is same, then that point is called a point of inflection. That is neither point of local maxima nor local minima. So that is point of inflection. In second derivative test, critical points we will find. Then we will not draw the number line. We will find f double dash x. We will find f double dash x, and we will replace that points there. And if f double dash x less than 0, that means if f double dash x is negative, then that point is the point of local maxima. And if f double dash x greater than 0, that is if f double dash x is positive, then that point is called a point of local minima. Then local maximum value we can find from f of x, and the local minimum value also we can find by using f of x. And here, in case if f double dash x equal to 0, in case if f double dash x equal to 0, then the second derivative test failed. So we cannot continue further. The second derivative test failed. Then we will do that sum by first derivative test. That means we will draw the number line. Then the same procedure. We will find the positive, negative, etc. So these are the derivative test. Then by using second derivative test and first derivative test in examination, in question it will not be mentioned whether it is by first derivative test or by second derivative test. So the second derivative test is easier than first derivative test. So in examination, most of the questions we will do by second derivative test because that is easy. So here, after getting the critical point, just to find the second derivative, replace that values, then we can decide there. But here we need to draw a number line, then sign, etc. So the second compared to first derivative test, second derivative test is easy. So we will do maximum questions by we will do almost all the questions by second derivative test. So now we are going to do exercise 6.5 we will do now. Exercise 6.5. So here in the question number 1, we need to find the maximum and the minimum values if any of the following functions given by exercise 6.5, question number 1. F of x is equal to 2x minus 1 whole square plus 3. F of x is equal to 2x minus 1 whole square plus 3. Then we need to find the maximum value and the minimum value. Very simple. We can do by first derivative test or by second derivative test. If you are doing by first second derivative test, f dash x you will find that is 2 into 2x minus 1. 2 into 2x minus 1 into derivative of 2x minus 1, that is 2, plus derivative of 3, that is 0. So 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 2x minus 1. Then f dash x equal to 0, that is 4 into 2x minus 1 equal to 0, therefore 2x minus 1 equal to 0, therefore x is equal to 1 by 2. We got x is equal to 1 by 2. Then if we are doing it by second derivative test, then we will find f double dash x. So when we find f double dash x, we can open the bracket or we will f dash x, when we open the bracket, f dash x will be 8x minus 4. So f double dash x, f double dash x, so that is derivative of 8x minus 4, that is 8. Then f double dash x at x is equal to 1 by 2, that is also 8, same. F double dash x because we don't have the variable x in second derivative, so f double dash x at x is equal to 1 by 2, that is 8, greater than 0. Greater than 0. So if it is greater than 0, then therefore x is equal to 1 by 2 is the point of, in second derivative test, if second derivative is negative, that is point of local maxima. If it is positive, then point of local minima. So x is equal to 1 by 2 is the point of local minima, and the minimum value we will find f of 1 by 2. So f of 1 by 2 we will find a minimum value, that is 2 into 1 by 2 minus 1 whole square plus 3, that is 2 are to cancel, 1 minus 1 0, so this is the minimum value. So this is the minimum value of the function. Find the maximum and the minimum value if any of the following functions. So this is the minimum value, minimum value of the function. But here in this question, and here no maximum value, this is the minimum value. So we have done it by second derivative test. And we can do the same question by first derivative test. But this question, no need to use second derivative test or first derivative test. By using our common sense, we can easily do this question. Without using first derivative and second derivative test, by using our common sense, we will do it easily. So you just see, f of x is equal to 2x minus 1 all square plus 3. This is the function. So we need to find the maximum value or minimum value. And here find the maximum minimum if any of the following functions given by. So x can be any real number. And here when we replace x by any number, this square will be positive. So when we replace x by negative or positive, inside the bracket you may get negative or positive, but when we take its square, it will be positive always. So plus 3. So we can write 2x minus 1 whole square is always greater than or equal to 0, because it can be equal to 0, because when we replace x by 1 by 2, then 2 into 1 by 2, 1 minus 1 equal to square, it can be equal to 0. So equal to 0 or greater than or equal to 0. So 2x minus 1 all square plus 3 greater than or equal to both the sides we are adding 3. 0 plus 3 greater than or equal to 3. So here that means f of x 2x minus 1 all square plus 3, that is f of x greater than or equal to 3. So the minimum value of f of x is always greater than or equal to 3. So the minimum value of f of x is equal to 3. That same answer we got by using second derivative test. So the minimum value of f of x is 3, and here no maximum value, because that depends. Suppose you are replacing x by 1 lakh, then 2 into 1 lakh, that is 2 lakhs minus 1 all square plus 3. That is a big number. If you replace x by 10 crore, then again you are getting another number greater than this. So it is going on. So no maximum, no upper limit. So it is going on. But the lower limit is 3. So the minimum value of f of x is equal to 3 and no maximum value. So that is this question. Then similarly we can do third one, third part. Second part I will explain, before that we will do third part. And here in third part f of x is equal to minus of x minus 1 all square plus 10. And the same, this question also we can do by second derivative test or first derivative test. But we can do like this. X minus 1 all square. This is always positive. It can be 0. It can be 0 or it or positive. Positive or 0 because it's square. But when we keep a negative sign here, then x minus 1 all square is greater than or equal to 0. But negative of x minus 1 all square is less than or equal to 0. When we multiply by negative minus 1, it is less than or equal to 0. If it is 1, it will be 0. Otherwise, it will be less than or equal to 0 because this square, this is positive. Then we have a negative sign outside of us. Then we are adding 10. So minus of x minus 1 all square plus 10. Less than or equal to adding 10. So this is our function, that is f of x less than or equal to 10. So f of x can have maximum 10 and no minimum value, because here also when we replace x by 10 lakh or 20 lakhs or 10 crore, then its square will be a positive number, then negative. That negative number plus 10, then no limit, it is going down. It is a so no lower limit for this function. But upper limit is 10, maximum 10. So we can say that the maximum value of f of x is 10 and no minimum value. Maximum value of f of x is equal to 10, then no minimum value. And here minimum value, minimum, maximum and minimum value. Minimum value of f of x in this question is equal to 3 and no maximum value. No maximum value here. And here maximum value 10 and no minimum value. Then fourth one. In fourth question we have f of x is equal to fourth one. G of x is equal to x cube plus 1. Then g of x is equal to x cube plus 1. And here when we replace x by a positive number, we can replace x by 10, x by 100, x by 200, x by 10 lakhs, x by 5 lakhs, etc. So the number is increasing, so no upper limit. And when we replace x by a negative number, minus 10, then minus 10 cube, that is another negative number, plus 1. If you replace x by minus 20, then another lower number we will get. So no lower limit and no upper limit. So we will say that no maximum and no minimum here. No maximum and no minimum value. Minimum value. No maximum value and no minimum value here in this question. Then second part, second part 9x square plus 12x plus 2. 9x square plus 12x plus 2. And here, one method is we can by using completing the square method in 10th standard you studied 9 we will take outside x square plus 12 by 9 into x plus 2 by 9 by completing the square method adding and subtracting here then we will get a square of one expression plus a number so like this we can convert this one then we can decide in previous question we have done the same way we can decide but I think it may be lengthy So this question we can do by second derivative test. I think that is easy. Like this also we can do. We will 9 we will take outside. Then x square plus 12 by 9 x plus 2 by 9. Then here 9 outside. Then x square plus middle term 12 by 9. 12 by 9 is equal to 4 by 3. Then multiply by 1 by 2. That is equal to 2 by 3, then taking its square, 4 by 9, then adding 12 by 9 x plus 4 by 9 minus 4 by 9 plus 2 by 9. In 10th standard, you studied this one. So, then the first 3, that is 9 into x plus 2 by 3 whole square. Its expansion is this one. Sorry, here I made one mistake. When we cancel this one, 12 by 9, that is when we divide 4 by 3, 4 by 3 into 1 by 2, that is 2 by 3, 2 by 3 all square, 4 by 9, adding 2 by 3 all square. Yes, 4 by 3, 2 into middle term, 2 into 2 by 3 into x, that is 4 by 3, 12 by 9 is 4 by 3x. Then simplify this one. Minus 4 by that is minus minus 2 by 9. Then open the bracket that is 9 into x plus 2 by 3 whole square. Then minus minus into minus plus 2. Then we can express the given expression like this. Then here we can replace x by any number. Then no maximum value and when we replace x by minus 2 by 3 when we replace x by minus 2 by 3 minus 2 by 3 plus 2 by 3 whole square that is 0 so the minimum value is 2 so, or we will write like this x plus 2 by 3 whole square greater than 0 so here x can be any real number when we replace x by minus 2 by 3 then it will be 0, then the value will be 2. And when we replace x by any number, positive or negative, then when we take its square, it will be a positive number, and that positive number we are adding to 2, so that number will be greater than 2. So we can say f of x greater than or equal to 2. So the minimum value of f of x is 2, and no maximum value. So like this we can do. Or we will do it by second derivative test, f of x is given. Then f dash x we will find the 18x plus 12 f dash x is equal to 18x plus 12 that is then f dash x is equal to 0 implies 18 that is 9 into sorry 18x plus 12 equal to 0 then we can take a 6 outside of then 3x plus 2 equal to 0 Therefore, 3x plus 2 equal to 0. X is equal to minus 2 by 3. Then, f double dash x. Then, f double dash x is 18. Derivative of this one, 18. Greater than 0. Therefore, minus 2 by 3. Minus 2 by 3 is the point of local minima. Because, second derivative greater than 0. Point of local minimum. Therefore, f of minus 2 by 3 is the local minimum value. F of minus 2 by 3 here, 0, that will be 2. Equal to 2 is the local minimum value. Minimum value. So, we got the minimum value 2. So, we can do by any one of this method. No? In this question, second derivative is easy. here we have to do it by completing the square method. So we have done question number 1, all the 4 parts. Now we will do second question. Find the maximum and the minimum values of the following functions given by f of x is equal to modulus of x plus 2 minus 1. So we need to find the maximum and the minimum value of this function. So here modulus of x plus 2, modulus of x plus 2 greater than or equal to 0. When x is equal to minus 2, its value will be 0. And when we replace x by any number, positive or negative, sometimes inside the modulus symbol we may get negative, but the final value will be positive always, because that is modulus. So it is always greater than or equal to 0. So we can add subtract minus 1 from both the sides, modulus of x plus 2, minus 1, greater than or equal to minus 1. So this function, that is f of x, this is f of x, greater than or equal to minus 1. So we can say that this function is greater than or equal to minus 1. So the minimum value of f of x is minus 1 and no maximum, because x can be any real number. So when we increase x, positive or negative, then its value is increasing. So no maximum value, but the minimum value is minus 1. So we can write no maximum value, minimum value equal to minus 1. So minimum minus 1. Then similarly, second part, g of x is equal to minus modulus of x plus 1, minus modulus of x plus 1 plus 3. And here, modulus of x plus 1 greater than or equal to 0. But minus modulus of x plus 1 less than or equal to 0. So when x is equal to minus 1, it will be 0. But when we replace x by any number, modulus of x plus 1 will be positive, but one negative sign is there, so its value will be less than or equal to 0. So we are adding 3, minus of modulus of x plus 1 plus 3 less than or equal to 0 plus 3, that is 3. So here maximum value of this function is, this is a g of x, g of x less than or equal to 3. So maximum value is equal to 3, no minimum value, because it can be any negative number, so no lower limit. Then third part, h of x is equal to sine 2x plus 5. The value of sine x lies between minus 1 and 1. Minus 1 less than or equal to sine 2x less than or equal to 1. Maximum value of sine x is 1 and the minimum value minus 1. So minus 1 less than or equal to sin 2x less than or equal to 1. So we are adding 5, minus 1 plus 5 less than or equal to sin 2x plus 5 less than or equal to 1 plus 5. Minus 1 plus 5, that is 4, less than or equal to sin 2x plus 5, that is hx less than or equal to 5 plus 1, 6. So the minimum value 4 and the maximum value 6. So minimum value equal to 4. And maximum value is equal to 6. Third one. Then fourth one. Fourth question. Modulus of sine 4x plus 3. Modulus of sine 4x plus 3. Then modulus of sine 4x plus 3. And here, we can replace by the maximum value of sine 4x. The maximum value of sine 4x is plus 1 and the minimum value of sine 4x is minus 1. And when sine 4x is equal to plus 1, maximum value of sine 4x is plus 1. When sine 4x is plus 1, then modulus of 1 plus 3, that is modulus of 4, that is 4. So maximum value 4. Maximum value is equal to 4. And the minimum value is equal to, minimum value of sine 4x is minus 1. So when it is minus 1, minus 1 plus 3. Minus 1 plus 3 is 2. So minimum value 2 and maximum value 4. So we can write the steps here. maximum value sine 4x is plus 1. So the maximum value sine 4x plus 3 is 1 modulus of 1 plus 3, that is modulus of 4. Then minimum value sine 4x is minus 1. Therefore, minimum value of sine 4x plus 3 is modulus of minus 1 plus 3. Reason here, 1 plus 3, modulus of 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. And here, modulus of minus 1 plus 3, that is equal to modulus of 2, that is equal to 2. So here, modulus of 4, that is equal to 4. Maximum value, minimum value. Now we have x plus 1. Fifth part, hx is equal to x plus 1. Here, interval given, x belongs to open interval minus 1, 1. So here, we need to find the maximum value and the minimum value if it is existing. So here, the interval is open interval. X belongs to open interval minus 1, 1. So in open intervals, the endpoints are not part of this interval. Endpoints are not a part of this interval. X belongs to open interval minus 1, 1. And here, x cannot be 1. So when we find the maximum value, we can replace x by a number near to 1, but just below 1. Just before 1, because we cannot replace x by 1, because 1 is not part of this interval, because it is open interval. So if you want to find the maximum value, you have to replace x by a number near to 1, but just below 1. But we cannot find any number like that, because if you try to find 0.99999, etc. But if we add one more digit there, then that number is greater than this one. So we cannot find a greater number near to 1 and just below 1, because infinite numbers are there. So we cannot find any number there, so we cannot replace x by any number. But we cannot, if it is closed interval, then it's okay. Maximum value will be 1 plus 1, 2, and minimum value will be 0. If it is open interval, we cannot replace x by 1. We have to replace x by a number near to 1 and just below 1. But it's not possible. We cannot find any number. And similarly, same problem we are facing here. Left side also, if you want to find a minimum value, we cannot replace x by minus 1, because minus 1 is not a part of interval. So we have to find a number near to minus 1 and just after minus 1. So we cannot find any such number near to minus 1 and just after minus 1, because if we add one more digit, if we subtract one decimal from there, then that will be more near to minus 1. So that is the problem. So here we will write no maximum value and no minimum value. So we have done second question. Now we will do third one. In question number 3, find the local maxima and the local minima if any of the following functions. Find also the local maximum value and the local minimum values. So here we have 8 options. So we have 8 options, so we will not do all the sums. I will explain fourth part and fifth part, and then rest of the sums you can do by yourself. So first I will explain fifth part. Question number 3, fifth part. F of x is equal to x cube minus 6x square plus 9x plus 15. X cube minus 6x square plus 9x plus 15. So our question is, find the local maxima, local minima of the following functions. Also find the local maximum value and the local minimum value. So we can do it by second derivative test, because that is easy. So by second derivative test, first we have to find f dashes equal to 3x square minus 12x. 3x square derivative of x cube, that is 3x square derivative of this one minus, sorry, minus 12x plus 9. Then f dash x equal to 0 implies 3x square minus 12x plus 9 equal to 0. So we can take out 3 outside. So x square minus 4x plus 3 equal to 0. 3 outside. Then product 3 and sum is equal to minus 4. So we can write minus 3 into minus 1. That is minus 3 into minus 1. That is minus 3. Sorry, plus 3 and minus 3 plus minus 1. So x square minus 3x minus 1x plus 3 equal to 0. That is 3 into, we can take x outside. Then x minus 3 minus 1 into x minus 3 equal to 0. That is x minus 3 common. Then x minus 1 equal to 0. Therefore, x equal to 3 and x is equal to 1. So these are the values of x. We are doing second derivative test. So next we have to find f double dash x. Then f double dash x. So we will find the derivative. That is 6x minus 12. Then f double dash x at x is equal to 3. Equal to, we can replace x by 3. 6 into 3 minus 12. So it's 18. 18 minus 12, that is equal to 6 greater than 0. So 18 minus 12, that is 6 greater than 0. So here, by second derivative test, if f double dash is greater than 0, then we can say that f of x is minimum. If f double dash x less than 0, then f of x is maximum, and this is the point of local maxima. And if f double dash, if second derivative greater than 0, then f of x is minimum at x is equal to 3. So we need to find the point of, find the local maxima, local minima, local maxima value. Find the local maxima. So f of x is minimum at x is equal to 3. Therefore, the point of local minima is 3. The point of local minima is 3. Then local minimum value. Local minimum value equal to f of 3. So that is 3 cube minus 6 into 3 square plus 9 into 3 plus 15. So when we simplify, we will get a local minimum value. So this is the point of local minima, the local minimum value. Now we have one more point. Then we will find f double dash x when x is equal to 1. So we will replace f double dash x here. Sorry, f double dash x. So here we made one mistake. Hold on one second. F double dash x. F double dash x is equal to 6x minus 12. So we can replace x by 1. That is 6 into 1 minus 12. So 6 minus 12. That is minus 6. So we can, this value is not important, but its sign is important. So it is less than 0. So we can say f double dash x less than 0 at x is equal to 1. Therefore, f double dash x less than 0 at x is equal to 1. Therefore, we can say that 1 is the point of local maxima, then local maximum value. Therefore, point of local maxima, point of local maxima is point of local minima here 3, point of local maxima is 1. Then local maximum value, maximum value is equal to f of 1. That is, we can replace here 1 cube minus 6 into 1 square plus 9 into 1 plus 15. So when we simplify, we will get a local maximum value, and here we got local minimum value. So like this we are going with this question by using second derivative test. So here it is greater than 0. Therefore, this is the point of local minima that is 3. Therefore, the local minimum value is f of 3. And f double dash x less than 0 here at x is equal to 1. Therefore, this is the point of local maxima and the local maximum value. So, we will do. Now, we will do one more question we will do from there. Fourth part, sin x minus cos x. Question number 5, fourth part. Third question, fourth part. F of x is equal to sin x minus cos x, and the interval is given 0 less than x less than 2 pi. So that is the given interval, and here we need to find the local maxima, local minima, same question, and local maximum value, local minimum value, etc. So we will find it by second derivative test. So here we will find f dash x equal to 0. F dash x equal to 0 implies we will find f dash x d by ds of sin x, that is cos x, minus d by ds of cos x, that is minus sin x. So minus already there, plus sin x equal to 0. Therefore, cos x is equal to minus sin x. Therefore, sin x upon cos x, that is tan x, equal to minus 1. Cos x is equal to minus sin x. Therefore, sin x divided by cos x, that is minus 1. That is, tan x is equal to minus 1. So we can write tan x is equal to minus 1, that is tan, we will write minus sign, we will write here. Minus 1 can be replaced by tan pi by 4. Tan pi by 4 is 1, and that minus sign here. So here tan x is equal to minus, then minus tan pi by 4. So that is tan x is negative in between 0 and 2 pi. In this interval 0 to 2 pi, that means here 0 to 2 pi. So here all students take coffee. So here tan is positive here in first quadrant and third quadrant. So here tan negative and here also tan negative. So we can write here this one. Minus tan pi by 4 we can write. Tan x is equal to tan pi minus pi by 4. Because tan pi minus pi by 4. That is pi minus pi by 4, that is in second quadrant. In second quadrant. Tan is negative, so tan pi minus pi by 4 is minus tan pi by 4. So that is minus 1. So this is possible. And here also tan negative, in fourth quadrant tan is negative. So we can write that is equal to tan, that is 2 pi minus pi by 4. Because tan 2 pi minus pi by 4, that comes in fourth quadrant. And in fourth quadrant, tan is negative. So, tan 2 pi minus pi by 4 is minus tan pi by 4. So, these are the values in between 0 and 2 pi. So, we can write that is tan x is equal to tan 4 pi minus pi, that is 3 pi by 4, equal to tan 7 pi by 4. 7 pi by 4 is. Therefore, the values of x, x is equal to 3 pi by 4 and 7 pi by 4. So, now we got two values for x. Now, we can find the second derivative, f double dash x. So, here f double dash x. So, f dash x is equal to cos x plus sin x. D by ds of sin x cos x and d by ds of cos x minus sin x minus into minus plus sin. Then, f double dash x. The derivative of cos x, that is minus sin x, plus d by ds of sin x, that is cos x. So f double dash x, then here we have two values, And here open interval 0 less than x less than 2 pi. So these two values are not included here. Then we will find f double dash x when x is equal to 3 pi by 4. We will find now. That is minus sine 3 pi by 4 plus cos 3 pi by 4. So we have to check it properly. Divide yourself cos x minus sine x plus divide your sine x cos x. That is equal to minus sine 3 pi by 4. We can write a pi minus pi by 4. Pi minus pi by 4 plus cos pi minus pi by 4. That is equal to sine pi minus pi by 4. Sine pi minus pi by 4 in second quadrant. If second quadrant the sine is positive, therefore minus sine pi by 4 plus. Then pi minus pi by 4, cos pi minus pi by 4. In second quadrant, cos is negative. Therefore, cos pi minus pi by 4 is, here it will be minus cos pi by 4. That is equal to minus sine pi by 4. That is minus 1 by root 2 minus again 1 by root 2. So minus 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2 less than 0. So if sine is negative, it is less than 0. So here, second derivative negative, so we can write up. Therefore, the point of local maxima f double dash x less than 0. Therefore, the point of local maxima, so this is less than 0. If second derivative less than 0 by second derivative duster, then this point will be the point of local maxima. The point of local maxima is 3 pi by 4. Then local maximum value. Local maximum value is equal to f of 3 pi by 4. So that is equal to, we have to find this value, sine 3 pi by 4 minus cos 3 pi by 4. That is same way, sine 3 pi by 4. Sine 3 pi by 4 we can write a sine pi minus pi by 4. Same steps we can repeat a sine pi minus pi by 4 minus cos pi minus pi by 4. Then sine in second quadrant the sine is positive, therefore sine pi by 4. In second quadrant this is negative, therefore this already one negative is there, so negative into negative plus cos pi by 4. That is sine pi by 4 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2. That is 2 by root 2. Then 2 can be written as root 2 into root 2 divided by root 2. Therefore, the final answer is root 2. So, this is the local maximum value of that function, that is root 2. Then the same way we will find the local minimum value. And here f double dash x when x is equal to 7 pi by 4. 7 pi by 4. Then f double dash x, that is minus sine. Minus sine 7 pi by 4 plus cos 7 pi by 4. That is equal to minus sine 7 pi by 4. That is 2 pi minus pi by 4. 2 pi minus pi by 4 plus cos 2 pi minus pi by 4. Then 2 pi minus pi by 4. 2 pi minus pi by 4, that is 4th quadrant. No? In 4th quadrant, all students take coffee. So, cos is positive, so sine is negative. So, here already one negative sign is there, that negative into negative positive. So, we will write a sine pi by 4 plus cos 2 pi minus pi by 4. That is equal to cos pi by 4. Cos pi by 4. Then that is equal to, so here we have to check the answer once again. No? Exercise 6.5, question number 3. Both the values the same, local maximum at x is equal to pi by 4 sorry, question number 3, 4th part. Question number 3, 4th part. Local maximum at x is equal to 3 pi by 4 and root 2. And here we are getting local minimum value equal to minus root 2 at 7 pi by 4. So here we need to get minus root 2. So here minus sign is there. We made one mistake here somewhere. F double dash x is equal to minus sin x plus cos x. Then so sin is negative here. So we will write minus sin 2 pi minus pi by 4. That is equal to sin pi by 4. And here in fourth quadrant, d by ds of cos x is equal to minus sin x plus d by ds of sin x is equal to cos x. Then 7 pi by 4, that is minus sin 7 pi by 4, that is 2 pi minus 7 pi by 4 plus cos minus sin 7 pi by 4 plus cos 7 pi by 4. That is 2 pi minus pi by 4 plus 2 pi minus pi by 4. So here it will be eight pi minus pi cos is positive, therefore sign will be negative. So one negative sign already there. So sin pi by 4 plus cos 2 pi minus pi by 4. Cos 2 pi minus pi by 4. Cos is positive, therefore cos pi by 4. Then sin pi by 4 is 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2. So here also we are getting same expression. So we need to check properly. Here f double dash x 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2, that is greater than 0. So here second derivative greater than 0. If second derivative greater than 0 by second order derivative test, we can say the point of local minima, the point of local minima is 7 pi by 4. So here second order derivative negative less than 0. So the point of local maxima 3 pi by 4. And here the point of local minima 7 pi by 4. Now we have to find the local minimum value. Same way, local minimum value is equal to f of 7 pi by 4. So here we have done f of 3 pi by 4. The same way we will find f of 7 pi by 4. We have to replace x by 7 pi by 4. And here also 7 pi by 4. Then 2 pi minus pi by 4, 2 pi minus pi by 4, etc. Then when you simplify, here you got a root 2. And here you will get a minus root 2. So that is the local minimum value. And this is the point of local minima. And this is the local maximum value. And this point, this is the point of local maximum. So that is question number 3. We have done 2 parts. So rest of the parts are very simple. Now we will do 4th question. In 4th question we have 3 parts. So we will do first part. Fourth question, prove that the following functions do not have maxima or minima. Fourth one. First part. f of x is equal to e raised to x. Then second bottom, fourth one first bottom, then second bottom, gx is equal to log x. And third bottom, hx is equal to x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Here, prove that the following functions do not have maxima or minima. So when we find the maxima or minima, first we have to find f dash x. F dash x is equal to e raised to x. And here, when f dash x equal to 0, then we need to find the value of x. When f dash x equal to 0, find the value of x, that is the critical point. Then that point will be the point of local maxima or local minima. But here, f dash x is e raised to x. E raised to x cannot be 0. E raised to x is always positive, so it cannot be 0. So f dash x cannot be 0. So we can say that there is no maxima minima. Prove that the following function do not have maxima or minima. So here we can write e raised to x. E raised to x cannot be 0. Cannot be 0. Therefore, f dash x not equal to 0. So, no maxima and minima. No maxima and minima. Here, gx, log x. Then, g dash x equal to 1 by x. And here, when we replace x by any number, positive or negative, any number, g dash x cannot be 0. So 1 by x cannot be 0. When we replace x by any number, 1 by x will not be 0. So we can write 1 by x cannot be 0 for any real number. Therefore, g dash x not equal to 0. Therefore, no maxima and no minima. No maxima and no minima. And here, h dash x equal to, when we find the derivative, we will get a 3x square plus 2x plus 1. And here, this is a quadratic equation. And when we try to find the value of x, h dash x is equal to 0, find the value of x. Then, if we can find the value of x, then we can, we may get a point of local maxima, minima, etc. But here, in this quadratic equation, when we find a discriminant, that is b square minus 4ac. So, b square is 2 square minus 4 into 3 into 1. So, 4 minus 12. That is equal to minus 8, less than 0. So, discriminant less than 0. So, no real roots. No real roots. Therefore, h dash x cannot be 0. Cannot be 0 for any real number. Therefore, h dash x cannot be 0 for any real number because discriminant is negative. Discriminant less than 0. In 10th standard you studied. Therefore, we can say no maxima, no minima. So that is fourth question. Now, question number 5. In fifth question, find the absolute maximum value and absolute minimum value of the following functions. And here, closed intervals are given. So, I will explain one of them. Question number 5, trigonometric expression, I will explain the second part. F of x is equal to sin x plus cos x. Sin x plus cos x. And here, x belongs to 0 to pi, closed interval 0 to pi. And we need to find the absolute maximum value and absolute minimum value of the following functions in the given intervals. So, same method. Here, when we find the absolute maximum value and absolute minimum value. So, this is a closed interval. So, we will consider the endpoints also. So here first we have to find f dash x, and when f dash x equal to 0, we will get the values of x. Then we will find, no need to find the point of local maxima, local minima, etc. So here it is a closed interval and we are going to find the absolute maximum value and absolute minimum value. So first we will find f dash x. F dash x equal to 0 implies f dash x d by ds of sin x, that is cos x, plus d by ds of cos x, that is minus sin x. D by ds of sin x is cos x, d by ds of cos x is minus sin x, equal to 0. That is cos x minus sin x equal to 0, that is cos x is equal to sin x, that is sin x upon cos x, that is tan x equal to 1. Therefore x is equal to pi by 4 in this interval, 0 to pi by 4, 0 to pi, tan x is equal to 1 when x is equal to pi by 4. Now we have to find the absolute value, absolute maximum value and absolute minimum value of the following function. So here tan pi by 4 is equal to 1. So in second quadrant, say tan is negative, so pi by 4 is the value of x. Then we will find the f of pi by 4, we will find the f of pi by 4, then f of 0 we will find the, then f of pi we will find the. So we can find the f of 0, then f of pi by 4 and f of pi. Then the maximum value, that is f of pi by 4, f of pi by 4 is sin pi by 4 plus cos pi by 4, that is equal to sin pi by 4, that is 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2, that is 2 by root 2, that is equal to root 2. Then f of 0 is sin 0 plus cos 0, sin 0 is 0, that is 0 plus cos 0 1, that is 1. Then f of pi, that is sin pi plus cos pi, then sin pi and cos pi, sin 0, 0, sin pi also 0, so here also 0, here 1, minus 1 for sin, and for cos, cos 0, 1, minus 1, cos 0, 0. So here sin pi is equal to 0, that is 0 plus cos pi, cos pi is equal to minus 1, therefore minus 1. So here the maximum value, that is the absolute maximum value, and the minimum value, that is the absolute minimum value. So here absolute maximum value, absolute maximum value is equal to root 2, and absolute minimum value, minimum value is equal to this one, minus 1. So we got, find the absolute maximum value and absolute minimum value. So absolute maximum value is equal to root 2 and absolute minimum value is equal to minus 1. So that is the question. Now we have question number 6. Find the maximum profit that a company can make if the profit function is given by Px. Profit function is given 41 minus 72x minus 18x square. Find the maximum profit that a company can make if the profit function is given by this expression. So by using second derivative test we can find the maximum profit we need to find. So the first step is p dash x, we will find the, that is minus 72 minus 36x, p dash x. Then p dash x equal to 0 implies minus 72 minus 36x equal to 0. That is minus 72 equal to 36x. Therefore x is equal to minus 72 divided by 36, that is equal to minus 2. Minus 2. So we have to check it properly. Vx is equal to 41 minus 72x minus 18x square. Then p dash x is equal to derivative minus 72 minus 36x. Then p dash x is equal to 0. That is minus 72 minus 36x equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to minus 72 divided by 36. That is minus 2. Then we will find the second order derivative. We will find the p double dash x. So p double dash x is equal to derivative of p dash x, that is minus 36, that is less than 0. Sorry, p double dash x minus 36. Then p double dash x at x is equal to minus 2. So here we don't have variable, so it will be minus 36 only. So that is less than 0. So here if we have variable x, then we will replace that variable by minus 2. But here we don't have variable, so the answer will be same, minus 36 less than 0. So that is second derivative less than 0. Therefore, we can say that the point of local maxima or Px, that means a profit function, is maximum at x is equal to minus 2. So this is the point of local maxima. So P of x is maximum at x is equal to minus 2. Now we have to find the maximum profit. So that is our part. Find the maximum profit. Therefore, the maximum profit is equal to P of minus 2. So we have to replace x by minus 2. So that is 41 minus 72 into minus 2 minus 18 into minus 2 square. So when we simplify, we will get a maximum profit. So that is question number 6. Then question number 7, you can do by yourself. Find both the maximum value and the minimum value of interval is given. Same method, we will find f dash x. Then when f dash x equal to 0, we will find the values of x. Then we will find the closed interval is given. So here f of x is given, question number 7. F of x is given, we will find f dash x, and when f dash x is equal to 0, you will get the values of x. Then we will find f of 0, then f of that value. Suppose we got three values for x, suppose a, b and c, suppose we got. Then f of a we will find, f of b we will find, f of c we will find, then the next endpoint f of 3. Then the maximum, find both the maximum value and the minimum value. From here we can find the maximum value and the minimum value. So you will do by yourself. Then we can find at what points in the interval 0 to 2 pi does the function sine 2x attain its maximum value. Then here 0 to 2 pi. Question number 8. So in 8th question, at what points in the interval 0 to 2 pi does the function sine 2x attain its maximum value? So 8th question, f of x is equal to sine 2x, and the interval is given, x belongs to closed interval 0 to 2 pi. Then we need to find the maximum value at what points in this interval. Same method we will do. First we will find f dash x. F dash x is equal to derivative of sine 2x, that is cos 2x into 2, that is 2 into cos 2x. Then f dash x equal to 0, we will find f of x is given, f dash x we will find out, and when f dash x equal to 0, what is the value of x that we will find out from that interval? F dash x equal to 0, that is 2 cos 2x equal to 0, that is cos 2x equal to 0. Then in 11th standard you studied, if cos x is equal to 0 implies x is equal to 2n plus 1 pi by 2. Cos x is equal to 0 implies x is equal to 2n plus 1 pi by 2. So all the multiples of pi by 2. Cos into cos, then all the multiples of pi by 2 will be 0. Cos pi by 2, cos 3 pi by 2, etc. 0. Cos 5 pi by 2, etc. So here cos 2x is equal to 0 implies 2x is equal to all the multiples of pi by 2, 2n plus 1 pi by 2, where n belongs to set of integers. Then therefore x is equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 4. So 2 we can take from left to right, pi by 4. Now we can replace n by integers, and here the interval is 0 to 2 pi. So when we replace n by 0, then 2 into 0 plus 1, that is 1, 1 into pi by 4, pi by 4 belongs to this interval. We can replace n by integers. So when we replace n by 0, we are getting. And when we replace n by 1, 2 into 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 pi by 4. So that is 3 into 45 belongs to 0 to 2 pi. So 3 pi by 4 is there. And when we replace minus 1, minus 2 plus 1, that is minus 1. Minus 1 into pi by 4, minus pi by 4 is not there. So minus 1 we will not take. Then when we replace n by 3, 2 into 3, 6, then 6 plus 1, 7, 7 pi by 4. 7 into 45, 7 into 45 into 7. So below 360, so 7 pi by 4 we can take. And when we replace n by, so when we replace n by 3, or 7 pi by 4, when we replace n by minus 3, then we are getting negative number, it's not possible. Then when we replace n by 4, 2 into 4, 8, 8 plus 1, 9, 9 into 45, above 360, 2 pi is 360, so when we replace n by 4, it is not possible. So we can replace n by 0, n by 1, n by 2, when n by 2 also we will take, one more we will have here. Once again, when we replace n by 0, pi by 4, when we replace n by 1, 2, 3 pi by 4, and when we replace n by 2, 2 into 2, 4, 4 plus 1, 5 pi by 4 is possible. And when we replace n by 3, 2 into 3, 6, 6 plus 1, 7, 7 pi by 4, 7 pi by 4 is 7 into 45, 360. But when we replace, these are the values, n is equal to 0, 1, 2 and 3. So these are the values of x. And these all values belongs to this interval 0 to 2 pi. These all values belongs to 0 to 2 pi closed interval. Now we have to find the our question. Find what is the maximum value. At what points in the interval does the function sin 2x attain its maximum value? So here we have to find the. First we will find f of 0, then we will find f of pi by 4, then f of 3 pi by 4, then f of 5 pi by 4, then f of 7 pi by 4, then f of 2 pi. So we will find these all values, then we can decide which one is maximum, so that will be the answer. So that is question number 8th question. Then question number 9, what is the maximum value of the function sin x plus cos x. What is the maximum value of the function? Sin x plus cos x. So that question, just I will explain how to do that question. So here, maximum value of a function sin x plus cos x. Question number 9. F of x is equal to sin x plus cos x. Then we will find f dash x. Divide of sin x of cos x and divide of cos x minus sin x. Then when f dash x equal to 0, that is cos x minus sin x equal to 0, that is cos x is equal to sin x, that is tan x equal to 1, therefore x is equal to pi by 4. Then we will find the f double dash x, and when f double dash x, when x is equal to pi by 4, then you can see it is less than 0. F double dash x, when x is equal to pi by 4, we will find same we have done in previous question, same way. Then the maximum value of function is this one, f double dash x, when we find divide of cos x minus sin x, and minus divide of sin x cos x. So when we replace here, minus sin pi by 4 minus cos pi by 4, that is minus 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2 less than 0. So f double dash x less than 0. So we will write down f of x is maximum, f of x is maximum at x is equal to pi by 4. So the maximum value of f of x, that is f of pi by 4. So f of pi by 4 is sin pi by 4 plus cos pi by 4, that is 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2. That is 2 by root 2, that is root 2. So this is the answer. Root 2 is the maximum value. So that is question number 9. Then we will do question number 10. Find the maximum value of in the interval. So that we can do same procedure. We will find this is closed interval. We will find f of x is given, f dash x we will find, f dash x equal to 0, find the value of x, then all this value we will find out. Then we will do 11th question. Yes, 11th question. It is given that at x is equal to 1, the function, at x is equal to 1, the function f of x, f of x is equal to x raised to 4 minus 62 x square plus ax plus 9. F of x is equal to x raised to 4 minus 62 x square plus ax plus 9. Attain its maximum value on the interval 0 to. And here, then find the value of a. That is our question. It is given that at x is equal to 1. At x is equal to 1. At x is equal to 1, this function is has maximum value in this interval. It is given that at x is equal to 1, the function attains its maximum value on this interval. Find the value of a. That is our question. So here f dash x equal to 4x cube minus f dash x is equal to 4x cube minus, it is a 62. Is 124 x plus a. 4x cube minus 124 x plus a. And here it is given f of x attains its maximum value when x is equal to 1. F of x attains the maximum value when f is when x is equal to 1 in that interval. That means f dash x at x is equal to 1 equal to 0. Means here when f dash x is equal to 0, then we get a point, then maximum value we will find. And here at x is equal to 1, this expression got a maximum value. That means f dash x at x is equal to 1, it will be 0. So f dash x equal to 0, that means at x is equal to 1, 0. So when we replace x by 1 here you will get the value of a. So that is 4 into 1 cube minus 124 into 1 plus a equal to 0. From here we will get the value of a. So that will be the answer. Now we will do question number 12. Find the maximum and the minimum values of x plus sine 2x in closed interval 0 to pi. Question number 12. We need to find the maximum and the minimum value of x plus sine 2x in this interval, closed interval 0 to 2 pi. So that is our question. Maximum and the minimum value. So the steps procedure same. We have to find the f dash x. F dash x is equal to derivative of this one. Derivative of x, that is 1, plus derivative of sine 2x, that is cos 2x into 2, that is 2 cos 2x. F dash x. Then f dash x equal to 0 implies 1 plus 2 cos 2x is equal to 0. Therefore, 2 cos 2x equal to minus 1. Therefore, cos 2x is equal to minus 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2. Therefore, cos 2x is equal to minus cos pi by 3. Because cos pi by 3, cos 60 is equal to 1 by 2. And here minus sign, same. Therefore, cos 2x is equal to cos minus cos pi by 3, that is cos pi minus pi by 3. Cos pi minus pi by 3, in second quadrant cos is negative. So cos pi minus pi by 3 is equal to minus cos pi by 3. That is cos 2x is equal to cos 3 pi minus pi, that is a 2 pi by 3. Cos 2x is equal to cos 2 pi by 3. In 11th standard you studied one formula, general solution. Cos x is equal to cos y implies x is equal to 2n pi plus or minus y. If cos x is equal to cos y implies x is equal to 2n pi plus or minus y. In trigonometry in 11th standard you studied this formula. So we can write 2x is equal to 2x is equal to 2n pi plus or minus y. So that is here 2 pi by 3. So we can divide it by 2. Therefore, x is equal to n pi plus or minus pi by 3. Now we have to find where n is equal to n belongs to set of integers. So now we will replace n by integers and all the values satisfying in this, all the values in this interval we will find from here. So we can replace n by different integers here. Therefore, it is this value. So when we replace n by 0, when we replace n by 0, we will get a pi by 3 and minus pi by 3. But minus pi by 3 does not belong to this interval. So minus pi by 3 we will not take. Then we can take n is equal to 1. When n is equal to 1, pi plus pi by 3. When n is equal to 1, pi plus or minus pi by 3. That means when we take n is equal to 1, that is pi plus or minus pi by 3. So that is LCM 3 pi plus or minus pi by 3. So 3 pi plus pi by 3, that is 4 pi by 3. 4 pi by 3 is 4 into 60. 4 into 60 belongs to this interval. This is 360. 2 pi is 360. Then 3 pi minus pi, that is 2 pi by 3. 2 pi by 3 also belongs to this one. So we will get take both the values. 2 pi by 3 and 4 pi by 3. Then when we replace n by minus 1, then minus pi by 3, that is negative. Minus pi plus pi by 3, that is also negative. So we cannot take n by minus 1. Then we can take n by 2. So when we take n by 2, then it will be 2 pi plus or minus pi by 3. When we take LCM, 6 pi plus or minus pi divided by 3. And when we take that positive value, that is 7 pi by 3. 6 pi plus pi by 3, that is 7 pi by 3. 7 pi by 3, that is 7 into 16. That is not possible. 7 into 16, 420, but this is up to 360 only. So 7 pi by 6 is not possible. But 6 pi minus pi, that is 5 pi by 3. That is 5 into 16, 300, that is in this interval. So 5 pi by 3 will take. 5 by 3 belongs to that interval, 0 to pi. And here we replace the n by 0, 1, 2. Yes, 0, 1 and 2. We replace them. So now we have to find the maximum value. Find the maximum and the minimum values of x plus sin 2x. So we will find the maximum and the minimum values. So we have to find f of pi by 3. This is a closed interval. So if we have closed interval, then no need to find the second derivative. No need to show that it is less than 0 or greater than 0. So we will find the values here. F of pi by 3. First we will find f of 0. F of 0 we will find. Then f of pi by 3. F of pi by 3 we will find. Then f of 2 pi by 3. F of 2 pi by 3 we will find. Then f of 4 pi by 3 we will find. F of 5 pi by 3. Then f of 2 pi. So we will find f of 0, f of pi by 3, f of 2 pi by 3, f of 4 pi by 3, f of 5 pi by 3, then f of 2 pi. Then from here we can find the maximum and the minimum. And the maximum is the maximum value of x plus sin 2x, and the minimum is the minimum value of x plus sin 2x.